What is the greatest design fuck-up of the human body? The awesome. There is an army of fully autonomous hunter/killer organisms inside us that will seek out and fucking obliterate anything harmful that they can identify as being a foreign threat. The miners suck when the identification goes awry and they fail to recognize a threat. The major suck when they decide a perfectly functioning internal organ is in fact a foreign invader. Autoimmune disorders are awful, awful things. Source: my immune system is really quite effective. It did a scorched earth number on my own pancreas a few decades ago. The brain knowing it's doing wrong, but still pushing itself to do it for some dopamine. Tinnitus. Hearing loss, sure, but a lingering constant ringing? Fuck that. That shouldn't be possible. When faced with substances it doesn't like, the human body can do some mild and annoying things such as make watery eyes and a runny nose similar to a cold, or make uncomfortable hives on the skin, but it can also react severely and essentially close off its only method of breathing, causing suffocation. Worse, these substances can be literally almost anything, including water, the body's own sweat, certain foods, exposure to certain animals, and various plants, and they vary from one human to the next, based on a variety of factors. Also known as allergies are stupid and fucking suck. This is more of a flaw in all terrestrial non-egg-laying creatures than just humans, but the body uses a lot of energy converting the ammonia our body creates while breaking down proteins into urea, so that it's less toxic and can be stored longer before being released in urine. Instead, why can't we just have a gland that stores the ammonia then be able to spray it out? Not only would this save energy, but it would also provide an awesome poison spray attack. One that stood out to me is when my professor said we are terrible at detecting oxygen levels. Also, I think this is more evolutionary, but the fact that we respond to psychological problems with the flight or fight response. It's like we can't tell the difference. Body is just like, stress. Have some cortisol. Let's go. Body gets me ready to fight a tiger, but I just need to do my homework. Fingernails are too damn fragile. Ripped off my goddamn fingernail last week, not fun. As for toenails, you cut the big one wrong and boy does it hurt, after being on your feet a long time. Your lever broke off the entire big toenail, that straight sucks. You can bite the inside of your cheeks and your tongue. Dunno, but I wish my tongue could clean my teeth like a toothbrush does it. Thanks for the death threats. The knees. For a body part that needs to endure so much stress, they are also very delicate. It's one of the most commonly injured body parts, and it doesn't seem to heal well without surgical intervention. Tear a meniscus? Probably going to need surgery to get part of it cut out, since most of the meniscus doesn't have a blood supply and can't heal itself. The spine. Sometimes I choke on water. Sacrum bone is just a fucked up tail and it really hurts if you fall on it. Because I have food poisoning right now, it would be how our body reacts to illness. I'm shitting straight water, have major stomach cramps, and I'm gassy both ends, and I know that eating food and drinking electrolytes will help me, but my body doesn't want it. I only half remember this, so hopefully someone can elaborate. Part of the human eye is arranged backwards. The optic nerve has to pass through it, which creates a blind spot. Some species have a more efficiently designed eye, where this part is facing forwards, so the optic nerve just plugs into the back of it. We are too squishy for combat. Your brain that just randomly decides it wants to die. Teeth. What the hell, I don't have to go twice a year to get my armpits scraped out lest they rot off. The fact that, since humans started walking onto legs, a part of the female population would just straight up die during childbirth because of the stupid evolution of the hip bone. Walking upright was just more important for evolution than fitting those goddamn babies through the birth canal. Thanks, nature. You have to poop, but it's not convenient right now. It's okay, there's a muscle you can squeeze to hold it. You have to pee, but it's not convenient right now. It's okay, there's a muscle you can squeeze to hold it. Your period starts, but it's not convenient right now. Well, guess what? Even though the uterus is basically made of muscle tissue, and one of its main functions is squeezing, you have no voluntary control over it. So have fun bleeding all over the place. Edit. Whoa. Jeez. Hi everybody. Thanks for the gold. Toes are weird. They basically are like low quality fingers. Neck and shoulders. Always in pain. Body. Needs water me. Drinks water body. *PES*. More water or you die. How common it is for women to die during childbirth. WTF nature? I did what my hormones were begging me to do, since I was 13, and you kill me for it? We don't jest at 4, as long as we should. We're near enough the only mammal that isn't up, and about a couple hours after birth, and that's because we have to get pushed out at 9 months. If we were in there any longer, the mother would never survive childbirth. A strange evolutionary error that leaves us uniquely open to predators at our most vulnerable. Hitting your small toe is really easy, and hurts like hell. Nutting has a cool-down period. Women having periods. They lose so many vital nutrients every month and run the risk of becoming anemic. Testicles. I understand the reason they're not inside the body, but damn. Could we not have evolved some type of bollock armor by now? Roll your ankle once, and it's never the same edit. Thank you strangers for my first silvers. Why don't limbs grow back? No valve on the balls. Allergies. It's just a freaking strawberry. Chill. Body. E. Two things I've learned from these comments. 1. Allergies suck. And 2. Allergies aren't that bad. Cancer for sure, also teeth. Let's make every bone in the body self-healing, except the ones that are under constant bombardment of outside agents. Those we'll just leave to their own devices, and if they start to wither away, then oh well. Aliens taking notes from this post, so they know our weaknesses. Women having to bleed and hurt for about a week every month, just because they didn't get pregnant. Running the male urethra through the prostate gland. Secondary drowning. Can also be called dry drowning. Basically, if you are drowning and survive, you still have some water in your lungs. Your body sees as a foreign body and will put mucus there to remove it. Then the body will see the mucus as a foreign body and throw more mucus at it, ending with you drowning in fluid that your body put in your lungs because there was fluid in your lungs. Fucking stupid if you ask me. A lot of these are just harmless leftovers or compromises that are actually better than the alternative despite their flaws. But can we stop and talk about that our spines are literally not designed to be upright in any way? That our brains are way too big for our mother's hips, Father John Misty. The breathing hole and the food hole are stupid clothes. The appendix in the human body is like the thermal exhaust port on the Death Star. I think it's just too easy to kill us. One stupid small thing and bam, the end. Not being able to synthesize vitamin C. That we can't process seawater.